Okay, gaming grognards, we are back once more on Hedgerow Hell, which is our liberation campaign where we're playing the United States in a hardcore medium setting campaign. And it's day 14, so we're on the defensive once more. So last time we came out of the last battle where we're attacking at Utah Beach with a fair crop of research points on the research tree. We've done a couple of things. One is we've spent the money, 5 points of those 11 on medium defenses. Now, you know, the jury's out for some people on defenses. I like defenses because it actually floods the battlefield with infantry and machine guns at the start of the game. It's effectively an extra calling. When you've got all your callings, when you've got all stage five callings, the only thing you can do is start to add defenses. And I think they really help out because they buy you time when you're on the defense to deploy your equipment. So we spent five there. We upgraded our infantry, so we've gone from rifle squad to glider squad, so we can get into the airborne and the really tough guys. They've got 300 base hit points as opposed to 200 base hit points, so they survive a lot longer in combat. And down here, we spent another rest of those points upgrading our anti-tank guns to the 75mm from the 57mm. We've been with the 57mm, it's served us well, but it's time to get a heavier anti-tank gun now that we know we're getting Panzer IVs, and we're not far from the Panthers and the Tigers. We need to upgrade that kit. So that's where we are. So let's take a look. We've phase one. Defensive, so we've got glider squads coming in here, engineers to dig us in, Browning, and a 75mm anti-tank gun. Phase two, we're bringing a 105 howitzer and another 75mm with another glider squad, more engineers to dig, a couple of Brownings to keep the infantry at bay, sniper, flamer, medic. Phase four, we're keeping this 15cm German artillery because it's got the range to bombard the enemy, and we can keep that supplied. Another glider squad, infantry platoon, and the first of our tanks. And then phase five, two more M4A1s, and then some cavalry platoons, some snipers, some close anti-tank, just a bit of a ragtag. So we're on the Seig River, don't know where that is, so let's go and take a look. We're defending, it's summer, we've got no choice. It's not a research mission, it's an ammunition. And so let's confirm that, and let's start. Have we seen this before? I have seen this before. I've seen this before. It's got lots of channels of water, so it's broken up. It's kind of marshy farmland. I think I might have defended this already in this campaign. I think it's where we set our artillery up and got into quite a big fight. It was an infantry and tank fight. That's hoping that our US airborne glider troops can, their survivability will help them in this combat, and that we've got enough resources. Not sure about the tanks now, because the land is quite close controlled, but we will see how much freedom of movement we get once we've held off the initial attack. Remember, we've got medium defences now, so we should see that early map flooded with our own troops holding on as we're deploying to back them up. There they go. So we've got some machine guns in there. We're just going to hit pause for a moment so we can take a look at the land. Excuse me. So we're down in the southeast, and we've got to make progress rapidly to capture. What have we got here? What are these? These hay ricks are not tanked. They're cut down trees. Interesting. Is this a train line? No, that's just a very straight road with water down the line of that. This one's mashed up with little dams. That's pretty defensible with that open terrain in front of it. That's going to be nice for guns, but it's whether we're going to hold two, and I think we have to hold two. We have to hold C, and we have to hold A, but we also have to be prepared to let D go. The distance between D and this one, C, is negligible. It's this area here. If I had some miners, I'd put some mines in there. But this one also has lots of open space on that side of it. I don't know where the enemies can come from. I'm expecting north, northeast, northwest, could be the west. But we can get our guys forward, and I'm going to dig in and support our existing troops in these locations. What have we got here? Yeah, these guys have got they've got an early Browning. the early end of World War One. They've only got low browning. We need to upgrade our defences again. Okay, let's get into this game and have some fun. So we've got a truck.
I'm ready.
And we've got our 75mm gun. This is the glider squad, so boys, you're going to go to there. And we'll get you dug in later. What's that? That's a Browning. We'll put you out on this side. And you engineers, you got the furthest run to here, and we'll light you some trenches over there. And we've got the gun, and the gun is going to go over here too. See, I'm not putting that right there, I'm going to put it right there. We moving? Everyone moving? No, it looks like that truck's not quite moving yet.
Always ready.
Just back it up. And then drive it forward. It's got stuck on the rocks. Get out here. So that's me just manually driving that to get it out of its position. And now it's moving. Let's get calling two.
Ready, sir.
They're calling two. That's another 75mm.
Yes, sir.
Some more glider troops. Put you there.
Ready to go.
That's a 105 howitzer. Now that 105 howitzer, I'm going to want to... where's the boundary of this? Okay, so the boundary is there. So we're going to want trenches there.
I'm ready.
Quite like that 105 in that gap there. And then one of you guys can come back for the other one. Okay, we've got a call in three. Like you boys.
Awaiting your command, sir.
We'll just get you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Get those dug in while you're doing that. You've got some mines as well, which is kind of useful. Okay. So you're smashing down all the walls.
Yes, sir.
Not clever. Come over here.
Yes, sir. Right on it, sir. Ready.
Put that gun over there. And then you're going to go for the howitzer. You boys. How do we get the mines down? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Somebody go and sort that out.
Awaiting orders, sir.
Yeah, you boys. I want a trench there. I want a trench there. Meanwhile, you're going to pop that gun down, and you can go back and pick up that howitzer. And next call in.
Gun ready.
Okay, these are the mortar. This is the mortar team. So let's get
no
you
problem.
Assembled up. Mortar, ammo.
Awaiting orders.
Mortar.
Yep.
You're going to move as one.
Ready,
more
sir.
More glider infantry. We're just going to put you out on that flank over there. That's another 75mm anti-tank gun. That's another Browning. We're going to put you up on somewhere in this field here. Because we're keeping that field as a killing zone.
We're ready. Hi, sir.
Yeah, I want this truck back here.
Yes, sir.
You boys,
yep.
Face that way.
We're ready.
Browning to there for now. First medics. That can be our medic station. Second medics. Put you over there. Right, get this mortar team. Kind of want you somewhere where I know where you are. And we can get you sandbagged in. Flamethrower out on that flank there. Bazooka team out near here, that crossroads there.
Ready to go, sir.
Artillery piece.
Any orders, sir?
Sniper, get you up and note that wood pile. And you're just going to wait there. All of you boys, you mortar boys, we wanted you down there. Fast as you can. You mortars? Yeah, you're doing good. Okay, here's the start of the attack.
Ready to roll.
Get that there.
What are your orders, sir?
On a couple of trenches ASAP there.
Ready to go.
Anti-tank in that direction. Okay.
Ready to go, sir.
Okay, we've got a four.
Reloading gun. Awaiting order, sir.
More glider infantry. Just over there.
Waiting your command.
Big gun. Command infantry. We've got a big push coming. One, two, three, four, five, six. Get those boys dug in. While we're waiting for trenches here. And another sniper out here. That's a big gun. F. Nice job, flamethrower. Nice job. Lovely position. Beautiful job. Beautiful job by the flamethrower. You go to ground. Really nice job. Gliders in there.
Stay low. Identify target. Ready. Let's go.
Okay, bring these guys back. And half of these glider troops into that trench. And the rest of you glider boys into that trench. Mortars are settled. You're going to come past that flamethrower again, I believe. There you are. Okay. Nice. Big rush coming here. Nicely dug in that water. Nicely dug in that water. Cool. The armor's all gone. We've got limited half tracks. What have we got over here? Yeah, he's good. Enemy bomber. Okay, so we haven't got any air defense. Well, he's practically single-handedly broken up. We might have some air defense from the tanks, but that bomber's going to come back and do some damage. Here he comes. What's it going to hit? Coming over there. There's the bombs. I think it's just taken out of our mortar battery. But you left the artillery intact. Yeah, the mortars have gone. The mortars have gone. See if we can help that guy. Wow. That was cruel. And we still haven't got phase 5. Let's get another howitzer down. And get some ammo behind that one. Could do with that gun being rearmed. I really need phase 5. What have we got here? A couple of engineers. I don't want to put you on that gun. Yeah, all of those, all three of the mortars are gone. Put the mortars, and I'll put that bazooka team in there. And see if we can draw a couple of guys from here to mount up that 50 cal on the flank there. And this medic, you're going to do a job here. Get some smoke on your boy there. Okay, big infantry rush in the middle now. The mortars are gone. Let's just bring this tank forward a little bit now so we can flank out this field. And get that flamethrower up, who did an amazing job from that position. Oh, that's bad. That was, what was that? That's a Panzer IV. So we really need call in 5 now. Leave the bazooka team concealed position over here. Where is calling five? Right, you boys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Get into there. That's cool. Come on, call in five. We need those two Shermans now to deal with this last bit of aggravation. Let's get this medic out of here. Out to here. That's just a truck. Put you there. Yeah. And the other truck, where are you? Okay, you've got the howitzer. Bring that howitz to bear. The AI defences are just doing an extraordinarily good job at keeping these boys at bay. Okay, another tank coming in here. Ammunition up here. I want crew pretty quick. There it is. There's five. So that's the flat gun. We'll put to there that was giving us air defense. Two Shermans on this road here. I don't want to face off directly against the German tanks without armor support. Glider team over there.
Yes, sir.
Bazooka team into the water over there. Sniper up to here. But yeah, that's a crew. Crews are there. I want you to reoccupy that tank. Sniper here. Bazooka team. Bazooka team here. And a crew. Right, the spare crew, we're going to put you into this building here. Right, get that gun down. Heavy. Oh, that was a. There's some engineers. We want this sandbagging. Get into that tank. Get out again. Okay, you can get that repaired one more time. Come on, support these boys. Well, Pyrrhic victory. We want the scavenge. In hell's name is that? Okay, medics. Okay, we've got a second crew. There. Okay, we've got to get the tanks over to here. Blood out there.
We're ready.
Okay, we need to shift some infantry. Onto that gun there. We want a medic. They're still coming. We can call this at some point.
Captain, I need a medic right now.
That's a Nebelwerfer. What? Okay, I'm going to call this battle now as a victory. I can't do the scavenge. I'm just going to call it. So maybe that's our screenshot, and we're going to pop out of here. Finish. Well, I couldn't fight against that Nebelwerfer. The tanks were down thin. We were getting a bit thin. We had the victory. We'd held it for 1,000 points, and so yeah. We've done better than that. The plan wasn't bad. We lost quite a lot of weapons and ordnance. We didn't cap anything, but I think we can recover on that defensive and then get back to an attacking game again. Wow, that was hairy at the end. A lot of armor. So 3.8 research, 1,200, 1,700 ammo, 2,900 cash. Still no artillery points, and we're keeping that 15 centimeters, so that's okay. So we've got some research points. What can we do on the research tree? Large defenses are aware where we're back on the attack. So we can push. The quality of the infantry, I was pretty impressed with the glider pioneers. I think the glider pioneers come with bazookas as well. So we're going to keep pushing down that glider route. And we could, I think, for 3 points, push our tank development. Now that we've got those heavier anti-tank guns, we could go for the mid-war M1 for 2 points. That seemed like a deal to me. So we're just going to take that as it is. That's research selected. We're just going to push that tank, given that we lost three, or we got damaged three. And those glider pioneers, yeah, let's go there. The gliders were great. Glider pioneers. I think they get flamethrowers with them, and that flamethrower over on the right flank was outstanding. Okay, I'm going to leave it at that. I'm going to go and look back at the video. I'm going to see if there's anything else I could do done to improve that game. But once more from me to you, it's a short game, which is cool. Thank you for watching. I will see you guys soon, and I certainly hope I'll see you on the next battle, which will be day 15, Operation 15, once more on the attack. But until then, from Gaming Grognards, from me to you, it's once more a bye for now. It's Gaming Grognards.